Dutch straits is complete, so that they can now also be poured into the fermenters. Here is where the biogas is formed. The substrates are continuously stirred in order to prevent layers of material forming at the top or on the bottom. A hot water wall heater heats the substrate to between 35 and 55 degrees centigrade in order to accelerate the formation of methane. On average, the substrate is in the fermenter for a period of around 30 days before it is filled into another fermenter for a further 30 days to complete the gas formation process. When fermentation is complete, the thin liquid substrate is pumped into two reinforced concrete tanks, where it is stored until it can be brought out onto the fields. If the fermenters are filled regularly with biomass, are airtight, heated, and regularly stirred, the biogas forms within a matter of days. The formation of gas is a complex and delicate process. The organic fats or carbohydrates contained in the substrates are digested by various kinds of bacteria, and this is a starting point for the development of the gas. If the contents are continually stirred, the gas rises slowly to the top of the container. It consists of approximately 50 to 70% methane, colored green here, and also carbon dioxide, water vapor, hydrogen, and hydrogen sulfide. As water vapor and hydrogen sulfide are problematic for the utilization of the gas later, it is necessary to treat the biogas now. The gas is first freed from water vapor, colored blue here. The condensation water is collected in a condensation shaft and pumped out. The aggressive trace gas hydrogen sulfide is now extracted from the biogas in a biological desulfurization plant. By introducing air into the container, certain bacteria cultures are able to establish colonies on the chain. Here they decompose hydrogen sulfide into harmless sulfur and water. The almost unpressurized biogas is then fed into a compressor, where it is brought up to the 70 millibar pressure later required for burning. In order to completely condense any remaining water vapor and to free the biogas from any suspended matter or silicates, the biogas is subjected to a washing and drying process. This is carried out with a vapor at almost freezing point, so that the gas is cooled down to a temperature of under 5 degrees centigrade. In order to control the purification of the gas, the biogas is constantly tested with an online measuring system, which records the amounts of methane, hydrogen sulfide, carbon dioxide, and oxygen. This guarantees a high degree of efficiency and security. In case of any overproduction of biogas, it is necessary to operate a gas flare, for unburned methane that escapes into the atmosphere is harmful for the climate. The biogas from this biogas plant enables two block heating and generating power stations to run and be CO2 neutral. To annually process biogas from 15,000 tons of biomass, this plant must produce a total of 500 kilowatts of electricity. Due to the optimal gas processing, the engines can run round the clock for several years with only a minimum of maintenance costs. Up to 30% of the waste heat from the cooling water of the engines is used for the heat exchange and the fermenter, so that no additional heat is required. The remaining heat can also be used profitably to heat industrial plants, houses, or swimming pools. The electric power generated by the generator of the block heating and generating plant is converted to the mains voltage level in the transformer. Then the electricity can be fed into the grid and meets the annual requirements of around 1,000 households. A biogas plant with an annual operating capacity of 15,000 tons a year requires 3 to 5 hours work daily. In order to keep the amount of work down to a minimum, we particularly recommend the use of an effective measurement and control technology from BioConstruct. Thanks to a safe exchange of data, it is also possible for someone who is not on the spot to monitor and control the unit. Should it be necessary, either the operator at home or the bioconstruct service team can intervene in processes in the biogas plant. For example, the agitators can be switched on and off. The levels of the containers and the pits can be checked, or the solid supply equipment can be monitored. Information about malfunctions or an expensive standstill of the block heating and generating plant can be registered on Bioconstruct's service computer or on the operator's mobile phone. This guarantees a short reaction time when anything unexpected happens and a reliable service by the Bioconstruct customer support office. Biogas plants produce high quality fertilizer as well as electricity and heat. The nutrients contained in the substrates are retained and are more easily available to the plants as the flow power of the liquid manure and its ammonia content have increased due to fermentation. The unpleasant smell of the liquid manure and organic waste has disappeared as the organic acids have decomposed. A biogas plant is therefore useful for both you and your neighbors. Why don't you also profit by using the smart, environmental friendly biogas technology in Bioconstruct's modern plants?